So, as you can see by the title, this video is all about making friends when you move. I moved right before my junior year of high school. I am going to be a senior now, so I've lived here just a little bit over a year, actually. And I made a video about a month after me moving in last September all about how to survive the first day and things like that. And on that video, I got a lot of comments being like, how'd you make friends? I'm so nervous about making friends. And for me, that's what I was the most nervous about. And now I have such an awesome group of friends. I love my friends here. I love my life here. I'm so glad I moved. But it was not like that for me at first, if I'm honest. It took me time. I've been in so many different groups of friends here until I found, like, the people that I just love and adore. And I was super scared about having friends. So these are my tips on how I made my friends here. Some of them you've probably heard before, but I hope this helps you out, and yeah, we'll go ahead and get into it. So my first tip is something you've probably heard before, but is the most important thing I think I could say, is to get involved with something, whether it's a club, it's a sport, it's a youth group, I don't know, like drama, band, something. You need to get involved. You should get involved with your school just in general, but especially with moving, you're not going to meet people unless you get involved somehow. I mean, you'll meet people, don't, like, get me wrong. But, like, you'll meet people in your classes and stuff, but you're not going to meet people that have similar interests as you necessarily, or you're not going to get to know people as much unless you do some kind of extracurricular activity. Plus, it's good to put down for college. Sorry, I think I'm talking really fast. Let me slow it down a little bit. But just getting involved is so important. For me, personally, I used to play sports at my old school, but my old school was pretty bad at sports, and I moved to a school that's really, really good at sports. We are state, district, regional champions at everything. So sports wasn't really going to be happening for me, so I had to find something else. I had gone to this thing called Young Life. Young Life is the best thing that has ever happened to me, by the way. I will put a link to their, like, the organization's website. They most likely have one in your area. I'm not even going to get into what it is, because that could be a whole other video about what Young Life is. But they had had it at my old school, and I did it every now and then. I was kind of like just whatever about it. But at my new school, I wasn't into sports and stuff, so I was like, I'm going to get more involved in Young Life. And that's how I've made all of my friends, because they have similar interests to me, and just some sort of activity, whether it's youth group. I think I already said that, but I did youth group and met friends there too. Just really whatever your interest is, it's just so important to get involved. And you might not have to stick with these activities, but definitely when you're first moved, you want to get involved in something, because it's just, in general, like, I sat around my house so much when I had first moved, and I didn't have friends, but at least going to activities got me out of the house and, like, got me around people my age that weren't just my family, because being around my family 24/7 got old when I had first moved, if I'm being honest, because I didn't have friends, so I just sat around the house all the time. And, okay, sorry, I wrote down stuff because I tried to film this before I wrote down stuff, and that was just a mess. Okay, my next tip is to follow people on social media, specifically Twitter, if you know them, and then getting their phone numbers just in general is so important, because that's how you can make further contacts to make plans with people. And just, I don't even mean like getting them because it's a guy that you think is cute and you like want to talk to them or whatever. I just mean like get people that you could be friends with phone numbers so you can make plans and for future social events. So my next tip is, going along with that, is to go to any social events you can and to go to the football games at your school. If you didn't move in the fall, then that might not apply, obviously, but, or if you live in another country, that football's not a thing, obviously, in America, which is where I live, is definitely a big thing. Go to the football games, even if you're not someone that's into football, that's fine. Go to, you have to go, you don't have to. You really should go to at least one. They're a lot of fun, and it gets you out of the house doing stuff. Okay, so for me, going along with the phone numbers thing, I went to a football game by myself. That was probably the most terrifying thing I had done. But I moved here, I wanted to go to the games, and I walked into the game by myself. Because the people I knew at the time, they were all going to go get drunk before the football games, and I wasn't really about that, so I made the decision not to go with them for that, which I'm so grateful I did not do. But I had someone's phone number, so when I walked in, I texted them and was like, I don't have anyone to stand with. Can I just stand by you? Football games are so great for, not when you don't have a lot of friends, because you're just standing there cheering if you go in the student section, which you should, for your first time. You don't have to, if you hate it, you don't have to keep going, obviously, but you should go to at least one football game in the fall, because you're just going to be, it gets you out of the house on a Friday night, which is great, because I was staying in a lot of Friday nights when I first moved, and it's, you can just stand by someone you don't even, like, have to know, and then you'll meet more people while you're there, if you're, whoever you're standing near, and you don't even really have to talk much or have friends, just have, you'll have found one person, I'm sure of it. Get their phone number, and text them and walk in. And besides football games, because obviously, like, sports aren't for everyone, that doesn't have to be, like, it doesn't matter if you're not into sports. Just go to any kind of social event that you can. I think I've said that like 10 times now. But, I went to just a random club meeting when I had first moved, and they were talking about, having some kind of volunteer thing on, like, Saturday morning, like, 8 o'clock, which I am not a morning person, especially on a Saturday. I'm like, I'm not going to get up that early. I mean, it's not as early as I had to get up for school, but it was a Saturday, and we were just going to be, like, mowing lawns and, like, picking up trash. Like, that's not fun. But I went to it, and I got to know some people. I got to meet different people. It got me out of the house. Like, if you're invited to anything, even if you're invited to something that's, like, that's not really something I'm interested in, I mean, unless it's something that's, like, against the law and you're not about it, then don't do that, obviously. But if it's something like you're really, you hate football games and sports and you're invited to one, you need to go, because that, for me, it gets you out of your comfort zone. And when you move and you don't know anyone, at least I knew absolutely no one, you're gonna have to be out of your comfort zone a lot, and it builds you as a person and helps with your social skills and just, it's overall helpful for life. I think that moving is such a great life experience, and going to things out of your comfort zone just builds you as a person. So any social event, whether it's a volunteer activity, it's something like a band performance, and maybe you hate music for whatever reason, I don't know, I'm just rambling, but basically go to something. If you're invited to anything at all, go, if you don't have friends. Because that's how you meet people, you're getting out of the house. You might not end up liking the people you meet. That happened to me a lot of times. I'm like, well, I don't like you, but it's more people that I can wave hi to in the hallway or something. I don't know. I'm not making sense. Once you meet some people and you are hanging out with them some, it is so important to meet their friends, because that's how you make more friends. I was friends with someone and I didn't know any of her friends, though. I was just friends with her, but then I met people that she's friends with. I didn't care for a lot of her friends, but some of her friends I did like, and they ended up, I found out, to be in classes with me, or, and some lived in my neighborhood and stuff. And just through that, like, when you meet people, it's important, once you get closer with them, to meet their friends, because then you meet more people, and then you meet their friends, and it's just a good way to get to know people, is to meet your friend's friend. My last thing I have to say about making friends is dealing with keeping in touch with your old friends. I think that is super important, to keep in touch with your old friends. I FaceTime my friends all the time. I text my best friends. I'm in a group message with them, and we text every single day. We Snapchat all the time. One of my best friends was just visiting me here last week. I think it's very important to keep in touch with your old friends, because it keeps you comforted when you don't really necessarily have friends around you. But one thing I found myself doing is when I was sitting in a situation where I was surrounded by people, but I felt awkward and nervous to talk to them, I would just sit there on my phone and talk to my old friends. And to an extent, that's good, because, you know, I was keeping contact with them. But you need to sometimes put away your phone and meet the people that are sitting around you. Like, if I was, like, at lunch, for example, I could have been getting to know the people I was sitting with at lunch. But instead, I sat there on my phone texting my old friends and just sat in my own little bubble. They were having a conversation that I could have jumped into, but I would just sit there on my phone talking to old people. So yes, it's very important and helpful to keep up with your old friends, but you might want to try to not focus and think about them all the time, because if you're just living in the past, it's going to be hard to move on with the present. I found myself constantly comparing my new school to my old school, comparing friends and different groups of people, and they're just, it's different places, different states, different people, and the more I was living in the past, once I started to put away my phone and get to know new people and stop comparing my old school as much to my new school was when I really started to be satisfied with where I'm living now. Once you kind of accept that it's a new part of your life and it's a change and you're not just trying to go back to the past, then you can really, I think, be comfortable and happy with your current circumstances. Obviously, I still missed home and missed my friends and wanted to keep in contact with them because we were close and stuff, but like, I hadn't fully, I don't think I had fully accepted that I had moved. Now, that might not be everyone, but I didn't fully accept the change, I just wanted to go back. But once I, that's not everyone, obviously. Some people might love and want to move, and that's great. And now, I could not be happier with moving. It's just the greatest thing for me. I absolutely love my friends here. I feel like my voice sounds like I'm about to cry. I'm not. I'm just tired. But I absolutely love my life here now. But it wasn't until I kind of like accepted and try to find like the good things about moving and like realizing how cool of an area I live in now and stuff like that to where I really was happy with moving here. And I think that's pretty much all my tips. Thank you for watching. Please feel free to email me. I will put my email in the description and comment. And I don't know if YouTube still has the whole messaging thing, but if so, message me. If you, I know for me it's really helpful to have talk to people that have gone through the same thing. And I am more than happy to help anyone else out. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day, and good luck to everyone moving. I promise you, it is a great thing, and such a cool opportunity. And good luck to you making friends. It does take time, but you can find really, really awesome people. I hope these tips helped. Bye!